issues in educational planning and plan implementation process. That is what we're going to look at in this video. Now, let's start with major issues in educational planning and plan implementation process. Right, the first is setting of aims and policy planning. This is the major issue. Sometimes some persons find it very difficult setting the aims and policy planning, because if there is no aim, you might not be able to come up with a viable policy plan. You might not be able to come up with a viable plan that could lead to policy that will impact the people. So we need to work out on the aim, which is very vital. It's a major issue. Then secondly, relating to planning coordination. No one man can plan. You need to involve all those that will help in bringing the plan into a successful one. And in this case, somebody needs to coordinate what is being planned. If you are planning for a school, for example, you want to site a school, you need a surveyor. You need somebody that will be able to look at or say, oh, well, this place, it is good. That is what you need, somebody that will be able to test the soil. You need somebody that will do some other thing. But however, you that is the planner, you have to coordinate all the plan and ensure that the plan means what it needs to do. These are major issues anyway. And sometimes you even discover that some persons you find planning for school, they don't even have idea about school system, and thereby they may not really know or maybe lose sight of some things that need to be planned for. Now we'll talk about issues relating to monitoring and evaluation, which is very vital. It's something that will always be planned for. Now, yes, we'll have the monitors and those that go about to see what is being put in place. But however, the checklist first and foremost need to be reviewed, and secondly, there must be commitment on what or the type of monitoring we carry out. And the type of monitoring we carry out will always help to enhance the quality of an educational system. Then we're talking about the participation. When you are planning, like I did mention, you have to involve all the stakeholders, because if you get all the stakeholders involved in the planning process, you'll be able to come up with a good plan, because from every angle the stakeholder will be able to tell you what they feel. But you as the planner, you now have to harness and coordinate everything that they have said that is being required, and in line with the policy, you now harness them together. Then you have to the issue relating to data and information. In most cases, it's always very difficult, especially in the developing countries, to get accurate data. And when you don't have accurate data, there's every likelihood that your plan will be wrong, because what you are planning with is a wrong data. And if you plan with a wrong data or a wrong information, definitely what you are planning on will be wrong. On the other hand, it will lead to chaos in the educational system. And that is why it is always very important that you have the right data. And in doing this, policy can emanate to ensure that the right data is being kept and the right data is being given during educational planning system. Then we have issue with the dynamic nature of education. Now, education is dynamic. Education is vast. And because it's vast and it changes often, especially in the method of teaching and learning, it changes. Like today, you see that technology is everywhere. And some persons are still finding it difficult to catch up with the technology. And you discover that if you are a teacher, you are not catching up with the technology, it will have a great impact on your teaching. So again, because the educational system is dynamic, you have to consider that when you are planning, because things could change. So if you are having a long plan, for example, you should know that because things evolve, especially technology evolve from time to time, then there could be a change. So in this case, you must work with that change and ensure you have a provision, you are flexible, so that such changes can be incorporated when need be. Then you have the issue of relevance. What is being taught in school? The programs that are being mounted in school, are they relevant? Are there things that are really required by the individual, by the students, and again, by the society? Will it help to improve on the economic status of the society? If not, why mounting such programs? These are the area of relevance that is being required. You don't just jump into mounting academic programs without looking at the issue of relevance. The issue relating to educational wastages, there are a lot of wastages, and how can we determine wastages in education? So look for the efficiency to find out how efficient a particular educational system is. Because if you, the amount of money you put in, is it commensurate with the output, that means the graduates that are turning, being turned out? If it is not commensurate, then it amounts to a lot of wastages. Now, the other thing we need to look at is the coordination and cooperation in educational planning process. Good coordination or cooperation will lead to what? It will lead to effective civilization of limited resources. It will lead to continuity in improving a instructional program, and it will lead to adaptation of education to the national economy. Because when you have a good coordination and a cooperation, definitely the utilization of resources will be on the top of it. It will be well utilized. You will give both to the students, to the teachers, and to other staff that will need to use it. But where the coordination is not right, even if the instrument is there, the resources are there, they may not be able to achieve what they need to achieve because there is nowhere properly coordinated. And since the instrument will not coordinate themselves, then we're looking at the continuity in improving instructional program. Again, the aspect of coordination, a good coordination guidance could help to achieve this. Now, the next one we want to look at the issue of structuring in educational planning process. Now, when you're talking about the structure of education, in some area is centralized, in some area is decentralized, and where you are using the centralized model, it means authority comes from a particular center. You take directive from a particular center, but if it's decentralized, then you can take out your information, or you could take directive from your immediate boss. In this case, if you look at it, yes, right there, in Nigeria, we have a certain substation in the area of policy that is centralized, but when you go down, you have that in each state, they have the autonomy to run their secondary school. And right there also, we have some schools that are federal. So again, the work that has to do with the federal is centralized, because it could give you principal and others, but the main decision board is at the central end. Now we look at the criteria for evaluating the educational planning structure. What are the criteria that we could look at? Then again, in looking at the evaluation process, we could look at the planning structure in the area of all-inclusive planning, because you want to include everybody. And if you're including, this will take care of why, what, who, how, why, what, who is going to do it. So you must involve everybody. Then planning structure. Again, we have talked about the structure in the just now, and in looking at the structure, you have different areas. Then you're talking about the research, the type of research that could be carried out, the type of research that will be done, that will help you to actually identify the area that needs to be restructured, the area that needs to be improved upon, or the area that is already good, the area that is nice that you need to sustain, and so on, and what type of resources are required. Then the data and information is equally required, and the area of continuity. These are things that are critical when you are evaluating a structure, educational planning structure. Now, again, this takes us back to the earlier part we just discussed, and that has to do with the issues of structuring in the educational planning process. Now, remember also, even at this, you're going to look at the local planning structure, regional planning structure that involve personnel, or the state planning structure. Now, let us see how, if you put all this into place, that your educational system, your educational planning system, will be able to attain what it ought to attain.